and then I also hit my head. I smashed my head quite hard to the ground. I think for me, this was the very first time I had a loss of my memory.
Good.
Fabi was sitting right next to the track and he seemed weird. Really, really weird.
Für mich war es jetzt im ersten Moment nicht so schlimm, weil ich ihn ja eigentlich schon öfter gesehen stürzen. Also von dem her war es jetzt auf den ersten Moment nicht so schlimm. Man sieht dann auf dem Video, ich gehe zu ihm hin und frage halt, okay, geht's, keine Ahnung. Dann ist er irgendwie so rum und dann hat er sich hingesetzt. Dann hat eben so Fragen gestellt.
He asked me and Hannes like questions, where we are and what are we doing here, what happened, how old is he? And then I realized, okay, something probably is not right in his head. I mean, I know that anyways, but something is probably wrong because of the crash probably.
I mean, the only thing I knew is that it's weird that I don't know these things.
It scared the hell out of me, to be honest.
When the crash happened, I wasn't there. I was editing and I got the message from Alex as he came running in and said, Fabio crashed. My mood immediately dropped.
Then the guys from Royal Hills, Stoika and also Nico Vink was there. They came up to me and they were saying, yeah, you'll be all right in 15 to 20 minutes. That's like they already experienced something like this before with their crashes. And that's actually how it happened. But then I instantly knew that something was wrong with my foot. I can remember getting up in the air, going sideways doing a turn now whip, and then suddenly hitting the front brake somehow with my finger. And you know, if you hit your front brake mid-air while you're sideways, then you know it's not good.
Oh shit, das kackt mir richtig auf.
Wow.
So schnell vergeht der Traum von einer X-Games-Medaille.
It's just laying there, thinking about my foot, thinking about the project, like everything kind of like was destroyed by that split second.
They said they're gonna figure it out.
I think it took me 7 hours to get x-ray, so that was insane.
Did an x-ray and it's broken, kind of like in two parts. And I mean, they say I didn't need a surgery, but I'm gonna go back tomorrow to Austria and then have a check there and see how it goes. Yeah, that's how it goes, and it's part of it. So yeah, we'll see.
So the doctor told me it's not a very complicated injury and it doesn't look too bad. So I was quite relieved at that point.
Auf geht's. Ich leg mir bitte überhaupt keine Lusche.
Alex, was sagst du jetzt?
Ja, jetzt schauen wir uns halt das ganze Geschmarre da mal an.
I got checked by a doctor here, got checked by actually two more doctors in Germany, and they all said it's...
Bad news is actually way worse than I thought it would be, and then the doctors in France said, and I mean, doctors here, I was in Innsbruck at a doctor and now in Munich, and they said it's pretty bad, like really bad. So need a surgery, and it's actually a super complicated thing, and it's gonna take a while, like a lot. So X Games will be definitely not happening this year, which sucks.
So it was clear I had to do a surgery, and from that moment on it felt like my daily life changed a lot.
My job is actually to take all the negativity and all the stuff beside the bike away from him. But that kind of meant that now he's off the bike as well, which is not cool.
This is the 18th of November. I'm making my way to Salzburg to document Fabio's start of the recovery. When we realized that this is going to be a really, really long recovery process, I was really bummed because I had the feeling that I kind of lost my job for the next half a year. Yeah, that was not good.
So right after the surgery, I instantly started my rehab.
Okay, so it's been a week since I had my surgery. I'm here at the Athlete Performance Center from Red Bull. I can work on and what I can do. Doing a lot of physio stuff, but also trying to stay mentally fit in a way. So yeah, it was good. Thanks Red Bull for the opportunity, that's amazing. And for the help. And yeah, I feel like I'm gonna be on a good track.
So it's been 2 weeks since surgery. And now we're gonna get rid of the, I don't know what they're called, of the feeding.
I mean, the doctors, Therapy Huber here in Innsbruck, like we were doing a lot of rehab, a lot of recovery things, just to get me back in the best way possible. And there were so many people involved, also Alex, who was driving me all the time, Laura, she was driving me, I think, for 2 months, every single day to the physiotherapy. And without those people, it would have probably not been like this.
So, wir haben es 8:40 am Morgen. Bin ready zur Physio, wie jeden Tag. Und jetzt machen wir uns noch ein bisschen Frühstück davor. Wie immer, Acai Bowl, komplett am Start, komplett Legende. Jeder im Haus liebt meine Acai Bowl. Ich bin's, Alex.
Ich lieb's komplett.
Ja. Ein bisschen Wasser. Alex. Stopp!
Ah. Yeah, also nutrition-wise, I try to learn a bit about that, which I never did before and which I never really cared. So, there were a couple of things which were also quite good. I take the whole city down with this. Wanna be down, wanna dash, wanna go fast, wanna be brave, wanna move like an assassin. Just to be frank, it's not for the faint of heart. And the only question left is where do we start? So anstrengend, das ist echt total. Guten Tag.
Danke dir.
Ciao, ciao, ciao.
So, wir sind jetzt fertig, beziehungsweise ich bin fertig mit meiner Physio für heute. Ja, also da verbringe ich einfach so viel Zeit da drin. Aber es geht langsam voran, auch wenn es wirklich sehr, sehr mühsam ist mittlerweile. Heute müssen wir noch ein bisschen was machen, ey, wir haben so viele Pakete, glaube ich, im Haus drin, das ist Wahnsinn. Wir werden uns jetzt noch ein bisschen anschauen, weil wir Weihnachten jetzt auch haben und das ist geil.
Noch was aufbauen, Burschen?
Ja, du wärst schon da. Alex baut uns heute ein bisschen was auf.
Chauffeur, Möbelbauer.
Was machst du jetzt?
So suddenly I was celebrating quite different milestones to what I was used to. Getting out of the boot for the very first time was a proper major step.
Oh, not a good day at physio. Today was definitely special. Finally, I was finally able to put the same weight on both of my feet, which definitely felt pretty good.
That's a good Vergleich, yeah.
Can definitely see a progress, which is great. And just can't wait to be back on the bike. And I think it's just gonna probably take me around 2 to 3 weeks.
Yeah, and then walking for the very first time without crutches. There was also quite a big step. Super cool, even if there was quite a lot of pain, but somehow we managed to go through it.
It's been a while. That's gonna be a special moment.
You put the key there, that's correct already.
Let's see if the muscle memory works, if it does. Okay, gas there, brakes there. Anything else I need to know? Probably not, no.
No, no.
I've been driving the simulator at home quite often, so got that race feeling in me. Fasten your seatbelt.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Them's on.
That definitely felt good, man. First ride in the Benz. Oh yeah. Getting there.
Next, what's this?
Hey,
Everyone is broken in the house.
Me, broken. Manager Alex, broken. That's not the Galec team.
And then it was finally time to go back on the bike, and it was actually a road bike. I mean, until that time, I didn't really know road bikes existed. You really appreciate those things a lot, and especially if you have an injury, you really appreciate the times when you are healthy, and it's at least how I feel.
7 Monate nach dem Unfall und jetzt haben wir Kontrolle. Es schmerzt aber immer noch beim Gehen. Das ist schon echt recht hart. Radfahren geht eigentlich eh schon wieder nicht so schlecht, aber es ist auch nervig, dass es nicht so einfach komplett geht, weil man muss halt immer ein bisschen zurückheben.
Der Knochen, Der war kaputt. Ja. Und wenn sowas in 1000 Sprünge geht, dann leidet halt extrem die Oberfläche des Knorpels.
Ja.
So. Und auf dieses Gelenk hat man ziemlich viel Druck, wenn man jetzt auf die Zehenspitzen hochgeht. Was ist das, was noch wehtut? Mhm.
Ja. Okay.
Der Knorpel oder das Fasergewebe, was sich da bildet, wird belastbarer. Beweglichkeit wird wahrscheinlich nicht dorthin gehen, wo es ganz früher mal war. Ja, echt schon schön.
Also ist wirklich gut, ja.
Ja. Und da drin.
Ja,
das ist die Ecke.
Ja, genau, selbst wenn man genau, selbst der Druckschmerz.
Ja,
genau.
So, sind jetzt gerade fertig geworden, also es schaut echt gar nicht so schlecht aus, jetzt nach der Zeit, muss man echt sagen, vor allem so wie es halt war, war es halt wirklich total alles im Arsch. Da war halt wirklich das ganze Ding ziemlich matsch und die haben auch sowas irgendwie in der Art noch nie so gut zusammenwachsen sehen, was eigentlich auch wieder super ist. Von dem her, glaube ich, sind wir da echt auf einem guten Weg und es schaut soweit. Ja, eigentlich echt ganz gut aus.
So beside training and all the rehab stuff, I was also working on 2 other projects. Those projects are 9 yard and bike flip. And I've been working on them for quite some time now, and even before the injury, but now through the injury, I was able to focus like a lot on those projects because I was not able to ride. It was also time to film a proper video project for the very first time. We went to Frankfurt. We filmed the first 9 yard launch clip, and I can tell you we definitely faced a couple of quite interesting challenges.
It's a trap, like you can't get out of there anymore.
While I was driving him to physios and doctor appointments basically every day for like 2 or 3 months, I slowly realized that es ist netzlos. Ruhe jetzt da. So after all those months of driving for... Das Kind sitzt hier nicht einmal die F***en, Mann. After all those months of driving... So after 2 or 3 months of driving for... Was ist mit euch?
Sag immer Mams.
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 Mams.